Hello everyone, Rudy here, and today I'm going to show you how to get started with Microsoft Power Apps. With this tool, you can easily and intuitively create your own business apps without needing to be an experienced programmer. If you never heard of this tool, don't worry. Because with the updates that Microsoft has rolling out, it's becoming easier and easier to create apps. So, shall we see it in action? Let's jump straight to the computer and create our first app. To start, go to the website make.powerapps.com. To use Power Apps, you need a Microsoft 365 account, either work or school. Another way to access it is through the office.com portal, where you can find Power Apps listed under All Apps. Now that we're in Power Apps, we can create our first app. Today, I'll use the template list called Asset Management from SharePoint, which is great for businesses wanting to manage their asset inventory. If you'd like to follow along with me, you can create your own asset management list directly in SharePoint. It's super simple. Let me show you how to do it now. First, go to your SharePoint site. Then, click New in the upper left corner of the screen and select List. Next, you'll see an option called Templates. Click on it and choose the Asset Management template. Done, your list will be automatically created with all the necessary fields. Now that the list is ready, let's use it as our data source in Power Apps. On the Power Apps homepage, click Create and select Create from SharePoint. Then we'll set up our connection by creating a new one or selecting an existing one. After choosing the connection, select the site where you created your list and choose the list. After that, click Connect. This takes us to Power App Studio, where the app starts to take shape automatically after a few moments. We're now in Power App Studio, and the basic app has already been created using our list data. To view it, click the Play icon or press F5. Here we have an overview of our assets with search, sorting, and add new record functionality. Since our list doesn't have any data yet, let's add a new record by clicking the add icon. The form appears, and here I can create a new record. Let's fill in the information and click the save icon. When we do that, we return to the previous screen and see that the new asset has been added to the list. If we click on it, we'll also go to the details screen, where we can view, delete, or edit the properties of this item. Now we can test the search and sorting features. Clicking on the sort option, we see that items are sorted by name, and if we type something in the search box, the items are filtered. We can exit the run mode by clicking the close icon, and let's explore the Power Apps interface a bit more. A quick tip, if you're in edit mode and want to test how the app behaves, use the Alt key on your keyboard to navigate through the interactive elements like buttons and icons. This makes the development process easier without needing to leave edit mode. Now that we've explored the app's basic functions and learned how to navigate the interface, let's focus on the left side of the screen where we have the tree view. This panel shows all the screens and components that make up our app. As you might recall, when we viewed the app, we saw it had three main screens. Here we have the main navigation screen called the Browse screen, which is where we land when the app starts. Right below that, we can access the Details screen and the Edit screen. Now, the Browse screen is expanded and we can see all the components that make it up. For example, if I click on the Browse Gallery Navigation Gallery, you'll see this component highlighted on the screen. Additionally, we can click directly on the screen elements like the search text box and other app controls. All these components are shown in the tree view. For example, if I click the Add Item icon to add a new item, the icon will be highlighted both on the screen and in the component area on the left. Now, let's make some edits to the app. At the top, the title is set to Asset Manager, but we can customize it. Just double-click on the text and edit it directly, or we can select the text property in the Properties menu and change it in the formula bar above. When I select the title, all the associated properties appear on the right side. I can also adjust the text, change the font size, and other options. Let's adjust the text here, change the font size and font weight. You'll see it reflected in the interface. Each component on the screen has its own properties. For example, if I want to change the type of information displayed in the navigation gallery, just select the gallery. It will be highlighted, indicating it's selected. In the properties panel on the right, we can choose the gallery layout, where I can simplify the display to show only the title and image. Let's save the app. It's really important to save the first time because after that, it auto-saves every 2 minutes. If you close now without saving, you'll lose your changes. So let's save it for the first time. Click Save. We need to name our app. I'll call it Asset Manager or Asset Manager App. I could choose the option to replace an existing app, but be careful not to overwrite an app that's already in use. So we won't touch that. Let's close this and click Save. It's saving. Done. Now that we've made a few changes, let's learn app navigation. On the left menu, let's insert a new screen. Go to New Screen and insert a blank screen. Now that we've added the new screen, look at the tree view on the left, and you'll see we have 4 screens. The new screen is still called Screen 1, and I'll rename it to Home Screen. Just click the screen and change the name on the right panel, or double-click to rename it. To make this screen the one that appears when the app starts, click the app object and go to the Start Screen property. Let's set it to the name of our screen, Home Screen. Next, I'll add some basic components like a text label. Microsoft is gradually releasing modern components, but for now, we only see classic ones. We can enable them in Properties, Updates, Modern Controls. Close the Properties panel, then go to Insert and Add Text. The modern controls in Preview shouldn't be used in production apps, but we'll use them here just to learn how. Let's resize this text and in the text property, type what we want. I'll put home screen. We can adjust the properties such as increasing the font size and weight. We can also center align it. I'll also insert an image into this app. Go to Insert and search for image. Place the image in the center of the screen, and in the right panel, under Image, I can choose Online Photos or Upload One. I'll upload an image from my computer that represents our app. I can also resize the image and change its properties as needed. Finally, I'll add a button to navigate to the screen with our data. Go to Insert, Button. Resize the button and place it just below the image. We can also add text to the button like Start. I'll increase the font size and let's set it up so that when the button is clicked, it takes us to the Browse Screen 1, which is the navigation screen. So by selecting the button in the OnSelect property, I'll call the formula to navigate to another screen. This formula is called Navigate. I type the formula, open and close parentheses, and inside them, I put the name of the screen I want to go to. In my case, it's called Browse Screen 1. Now, if I press Alt on my keyboard or press Play, I can click the button and it'll take me to the other screen. Now that we've explored the basic interface and created a simple app, let's share it with our colleagues. In the top right corner, save it first, as we've already seen. And now that the app is saved, let's publish it to make this the most recent version available for use. Click Publish, confirm by clicking Publish this version. With the app published, we have a Share button here. Clicking it opens a new tab, the Sharing panel. I'll add some names. These are the people who will have access to the app. Now that I've added the names, I can adjust the permissions. If I want these people to edit the app as well, I mark them as co-workers. I can also add a message and image to be sent with an invitation email. If I don't want to send the email, I can uncheck Send Email Invitation to New Users. You don't want to share an app if people don't have access to the data, as they won't see anything in the app. click Share, and it's done. Back on the Power Apps homepage, if I want to run my app, I can go to Apps, and my app is here ready to run. I click Run, and it opens the app I published. I grant permissions to access the data sources, and the app is running. Let's test our button. And it navigated to the assets screen. The app is running. I can also click Share, send a link via email, copy the link to share with colleagues, or embed it in Teams. If you like this video, leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more tutorials and tips on Power Apps and other Microsoft Power Platform tools. Don't forget to check the links in the description and the pinned comment. Leave your suggestions or questions in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.